Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Savitri from All Things Beautiful, and today I'm here with a very interesting recycle or upcycle project with your old chapati or roti rolling board. So what we need is some colors and rolling board and some stencils that you have. So I had this old wooden chapati rolling board. I don't use it anymore. I roll it straight away on my slab. So it has been lying with me for a very long time, and finally I decided to recycle it. So what I'm doing here is just painting the base in black fully with chalk paints. The reason I'm giving a black coat is because I want to give it a distressed look, so I want a black background. I'm just turning over the board now and removing all the wood scraps or whatever, and painting the back also in black. So once we do this, I will let it dry completely. Now, to give it a distressed look, what I'm doing is I'm taking a wax candle and I'm just rubbing the candle all over my board wherever I want the distressed look or effect to come. And once I do that, I just wipe off the board and I'll paint the color that I want to on top. And I'm using a teal blue here. It's a light teal blue shade. I have mixed some white and randomly brushed the colors all over my board. I don't want a very smooth finish, so I just brushed some white here and there and the teal. So here today I'm planning to make like a razor or a table stand, or we can even use it as a cupcake or a cake stand. So this is optional. If you want, you can do this. You can finish the project and just keep it on the table, or you can do this step. Take any plastic cup that you have, which is you know, little heavy duty or firm, not too flimsy, and color it in the same color as your board. So we will be sticking this cup under the board to give it like a riser or a stand. So yeah, we have done with the painting completely and my paint is completely dry. So to give it that distressed look, what I'll do now is take a sandpaper and just lightly rub all over the area that I have put the candle. So what this does is wherever there is candle, the paint wouldn't have got caught on the board, so it will just scrape off and come. So wherever I had rubbed the candle, the top paint layer will come off and you will get the back underlying paint seen over. So that is what gives it a distressed or the old charm look. So this technique can be used in various different ways in all your projects. So that is a distress, easy distress work. And now all I'm going to do is simply stencil something onto my board. I have this beautiful stencil from iCraft here. It's a very nice, like a vintage kind of a stencil. I'm only going to stencil the center part where it says love with that oval thing, which will actually fit on my board perfectly fine. I am going to stencil this design in black. A very important thing you should remember while stenciling, if you want a very crisp image when you stencil, you should not take too much paint, too much product on your brush. You have to just lightly tap the brush in the paint, and you have to take off, brush off the excess on a tissue paper or on a rag cloth, and only the remaining brush, whatever paint is left on the brush, you have to go over the stencil. You can either dab this stencil with your brush, or you can go over the stencil in a circular motion. Both will give you two different effects, so you can try both. But one important thing is never take too much product on your brush. If you're going to take too much product, it will bleed under the stencil and you will not get a crisp image. So that's a finished beautiful board. It looks really, really pretty. Very simple stencil on a very simple distressed board. Nothing much. This is a very, very easy project. And just to give it some additional accent, I have this decoupage paper with me. I thought the butterfly colors match very well with the color of my board. So I'm just going to cut out two butterflies and just decoupage them on two different places on my board. So that's a beautiful rolling board with stenciling work and decoupage work ready. It's absolutely gorgeous, very simple but gorgeous. And once everything is, I'm just touching up here with some black just to give it some outline and some depth to the butterflies. Just giving them an outline in black chalk paint, nothing much. So yeah, so that's a finished board. And now I will just give it a, once it dries completely, I will give it a nice coat of varnish. I'm using the water-based Aquadar PU exterior varnish here. You can also use interior varnish if you're going to keep your products inside the house. But since I'm just going to use it as a decor piece, I'm just giving like one single coat. But if you're going to use it for say tea or coffee or anything, I suggest you give at least three coats. Leave 2 days between each coat. Now to use it as a cake stand or a riser on your table, all you have to do is just stick that glass under your board. So to give it more strength, I'm just putting a cardboard, cutting a cardboard in a circular shape, same size as the mouth of the glass, just to give it more sturdiness. I will stick the cardboard and then I'll stick the whole the cardboard with the glass onto the board. And I'm using a silicone gel here. You can use any industrial grade strong glue, Fevibond or anything which would stay strong is fine. You can use E6000 or silicone glue or any industrial strong resin kind of a glue. Put something heavy on top of the glue and leave it overnight for it to dry, and there you go, a beautiful recycle or upcycle chapati board riser or cake stand is ready. It's absolutely gorgeous. You can use it as a decor piece, or you can just use it to display your cake or cupcake or anything. If you don't want to put the glass, you can just keep it on your table just as a riser, or you can even use it as a wall decor piece as well without the glass. Just hang it anywhere on your wall in a garden or anywhere to give your wall a nice accent and some color. So yeah, hope you like it. It's very, very simple. If you have a chapati rolling board or roti rolling board, please do try. And it's a simple project, but the outcome is really gorgeous and beautiful, and you get an absolutely beautiful decor piece in your home. That's for today, guys. Hope you liked my video. Hope you liked the ideas. If you do, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and show some love. Thank you so much. Do follow me on Facebook as well, and also on Instagram. Thank you once again. Enjoy your day and happy crafting.